Coast Life, we know that summertime is a great time of year for our people visitor friends.
Yes.
But winter is a great time of year for our feathered visitor friends.
Ooh, okay.
Joining us on the Coast Life couch today, Jim Rapp with Delmarva Birding Weekends to tell us about some of those feathered winter bird friends. Yes.
Thanks for having me. Love being here with you guys.
We love having you.
So temperatures are dropping. Mm-hmm. We're heading into the winter months. Mm-hmm. Who can people spot on their winter adventures?
It's funny you said who.
Yeah.
So, you know, to kick it off before I give that one away, if I already didn't, you know, winter is a remarkable time of year. I know for many of us, it's like stay inside, it's mm-hmm. cozy, comfy in the house, but get outside because already this year, what are we at, like early January,
yep.
I'll use the word snow, right? Mm-hmm. So snow buntings. These are little white sparrow type birds that nest way up in the Arctic. They actually turn white in the summertime. They blend in with the snow there. But they're here on like the Delaware Bay Shore beaches. Snow geese, mm-hmm. most mm-hmm. locals are familiar with the
yes.
big flocks of snow geese that come in. Same thing, another Arctic nester. But we've seen reports of this year's first snowy owls on
Yay!
The beaches.
Oh my
so
gosh.
Those are three birds right there that kind of, I know for birders, it captures the imagination, but snowy owls, because of Hedwig, I guess I'm Harry Potter,
yeah.
everybody loves snowy owls.
Yes.
So yeah, those birds are here, winter waterfowl. I mean, there's up to 30 some species you can see on a good day of birding.
Mm-hmm.
It's really great.
Yes, I know, I went for a walk, I think, yeah, over the weekend. We saw some of the bufflehead ducks that came to town. I'm very excited that I ID'd them correctly. But with the snowy owls, I know that a lot of like responsible photographers won't disclose the location
right.
that they're seeing the snowy owls.
Oh,
so
you can't?
They're too protected. It's too.
I was going to ask you where I can go see them.
Well, I'll give you some general guidance.
Can we get some pointers?
Yeah.
And I'm glad you brought that up because, right, as birders, wildlife photographers, most people out there are really good about this. When these birds come mm-hmm. here, they're migrating, mm-hmm. I mean, sometimes thousands of miles.
Yeah.
And when they first get here, just like we would be, they're tired, they're mm-hmm. hungry, they just don't need the paparazzi like gathered around them. And within every group of people, there's always a few that want to like, well, I'm going to get a little bit closer than you're going to mm-hmm. get, or I want to try to throw some food or mm-hmm. try to make it fly. Not cool. And if you're on like refuge property, you can mm-hmm. actually be told to leave. So our encouragement is, yes, go see them, to answer your question.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, the best places are the beaches. I mean, I've mm-hmm. seen them in the past at Cape Henlopen on the sand dunes there. Assateague Island National Seashore. There's not many, and it's a lucky thing to see them. But if you do get lucky, just please stay back. If you see the bird get agitated, just stop moving forward. And that's it, really.
They'll give you, they'll let you know.
I do have a little Hedwig that sits on my desk. That's why I was so excited to maybe see one.
Well, and, they're occasionally, and I don't know yet this year, who knows, there have been some years where there's, like a couple dozen down here.
Wow.
Some years it's one or two. Every year it's a little bit different. And there's a whole really cool thing about that, why they migrate the way they do. Mm-hmm. But the cool thing about our region is we have the habitat. We've got the refuges. We've got the parks, the beaches, the bays. And so all the species of birds we've talked about already, this is the perfect winter place. Like a lot of us go south, mm-hmm. we are the south for them.
Right? Good point. Okay.
Very true.
Yeah, I didn't think about that because I guess wherever they're coming from is colder, lot colder.
Well, it's colder, it's snow and ice cover. So mm-hmm. think about hunting or fishing mm-hmm. like the Great Lakes. If they're mm-hmm. frozen and you're a loon, you can't get under that ice. You've got to go where the ice thaws.
Mm-hmm.
So as the cold weather pushes south, those Arctic birds who love it up there in the summertime really do prefer our waters and beaches and stuff in the wintertime.
Yeah,
interesting.
Makes a lot of sense.
Yeah. We have other visitors too,
right?
I knew what you were thinking. Yeah.
Yes, indeed.
They don't have feathers, though.
No, they don't. So, right, this has been a kind of not a new thing for Delmarva, but a recent thing that we've started with tours are seals.
Mm-hmm.
And so, particularly in the Lewis area, the breakwater walls where the beautiful mm-hmm. lighthouses are off Cape Henlopen, in January, really December through even April,
mm-hmm.
can be really incredible hangouts for both harbor seals, mm-hmm. they're the smaller ones, like 200, 300 pounds, pug face, kind of like puppy dog, to the really big gray seals. I mean, the bulls can be 800 pounds, big horsey snout. And so on the tours that we run, we'll see them out in the breakwater walls, mm-hmm. Hauled out on the rocks. It's amazing. It's like going to Maine for the afternoon, and it's here in Lewis, Delaware.
How amazing is that?
Now, do you have some tours that are still available for people who are interested?
Thanks for asking. Yeah, we've got tours really from the first weekend of January all the way into April now. And,
right?
and with that, it's birds, it's seals, a little history, and a lot of fun, too. We have great partners at Dogfish Head, so we go have a beer at night and tally the birds we've seen. It's a really tremendously fun time.
I've definitely perused the available dates myself.
Yes.
Love
definitely.
To have you. Anyway.
Yes.
So where should people go who are interested in booking booking a tour.
Sure. It's basically delmarvabirding.com, mm-hmm. and all our tours are there. And it's funny because even though we're running the winter tours now, it's also like we'll see in the spring.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Spring and summer come. We're always like one step ahead of the seasons. But the year round here, as we've talked many times before, is just fabulous for birding and wildlife watching. So get out on your own.
Definitely. Awesome. We always learn so much when you're here. Thank you.
Love having you. Thank
yes, we love having you here, Jim. And again, you're a wealth of information.
Yes.
And it's fun to go through and ID all the critters that we see any time of year mm-hmm. here on Delmarva. But we've got some more critters to introduce you to, possibly your new forever friend with Ooh. Our pet of the week that's on the way on Coast Life. So stick around.